till 4. They were young and they had each other. Who could ask for more at the Copa, Copa Cabana? The hottest spot north of Havana. At the Copa, Copa Cabana. Music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa. They fell in love. His name was Rico. He wore a diamond. He was escorted to his chair. He saw Lola dancing there, and when she finished, he called her over. But Rico went a bit too far. Tony sailed across the bar, and then the punches flew, and chairs were smashed in two. There was blood and a single gunshot, but just who shot who?
Gorgeous George, Merry, Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year. Kayla Czar is in the house. How you doing, Kay?
Hey, how you doing, Gorgeous George? It's so great to hear music for a change on the radio. I haven't heard music on the radio, oh man, since all those took over radio.
We're out here, and we got an hour and a half tonight of the Gorgeous George Show, up till 10:30 tonight. We're out here, and we've what? You say what?
10:30. Long show. We're going to tell our affiliates that we're going to go on for an extra half hour. So all you folks listening online, enjoy the show. We got an extra. We have a half hour bonus.
The bonus. The bonus is what it's about. I wanted to start off right now by saying that it's back. It's good to be back on radio. We were the Gorgeous George Show. It's the 16 years on TV. We've been doing it 16 years on TV, and now we've breaking the airwaves and radio, and we're doing the Christmas show on radio, and I've got something to say for all my fans out there. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house. Not a puss was stirring, not the one even under your blouse. Everything was hung in care, the stockings and the pantyhose were hung in care, that soon, that Gorgeous George would soon come there. And every sister wants to see how many inches that Gigi will stick it in them. So once again, I'm offering this simple phrase, la, da, 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 from females, from however old they are. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Clitmas, la, da, da, da. Merry Clitmas, and let me bust your cherry, dun, dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun. Woo!
I wrote the music to that song. I actually met him. Mel Torme, the most famous song he ever wrote, the Christmas song. Yeah.
All right, we got a lot to get into right now. We're going to get into it. Christmas is a time for giving. Christmas is a time for helping people cross the street, helping the old lady cross the street. Christmas is a time for good things and to reflect. But I am going to now get into a little something that is getting a little bit under my skin. And I'm going to address this. Now, you and I have been, you've been on the show since 1997. And you've been a great asset for what you do. Everything you've done has been great. You are a great add-on to the show. Always have been and always will be. I've always said that. What's that?
The Gorgeous George Show, and you're the star of the show. And what you say goes.
That's right. And I have, at least you acknowledge that, and I hope you'll still acknowledge that after we get into some more stuff. What's going on there? The phone keeps ringing. Is there a way we can knock that thing out for now? I mean, can we just turn it up for the time being? Take it off the hook? Take it off the hook, okay. Oh, take this right out here. Is that going to stop it? That's going to stop it. All right, we're not taking phone calls until I'm ready to take phone calls. So I'll just pull the cord out, and it's still ringing after we pull the, I pull the actual switch out, and it's still ringing. Put the cord back in, and then what? Just like that? Okay, so anyway, that's like how we do it. All right, so here we go. Now, we want to address this. Kevin, we're on radio back April 15th on tax season, and we wanted to clear the air, let people know what we're about, what we do. We are a comedy show for 16 years. We have the Gorgeous George Show 2010. It's on DVD. It's been on, we just put that out. We have other things that we've been doing, other stuff that's been going on, and we are very proud to announce that the 2010 DVD is out. We'll be out actually after Christmas, but we have some stuff on YouTube. I want to address some things. I'm going to address something that happened here. As we know, there are a lot of people out there that like to destruct rather than construct. And we don't give these people the time of day. And I hate to do this, but I got to, rather than construct. There's a certain thing that happened. Kevin has a lot of fans on Facebook, so do I. The only difference between my Facebook and Kevin's Facebook is closed off to only my friends. Kevin, on the other hand, has his Facebook open up to a lot of people, but that my Facebook, and I have a lot of friends on Facebook, but he has it open to something happened just recently where they contacted all of your friends or most of your friends on Facebook trying to gather up information. These are the desperate imbeciles that after we did the show back on April 15th at WCLM kept calling the station for about 2 to 3 months after the fact to see if we were on station. We were coming back on. I just was told this. They kept calling the station to see if we were back being. Don't like to give the attention to these people. I don't like to give the attention to these people. To give these people the time of freaking day. You know, it's Christmas, and I'm going to let it rip, okay? I don't like these assholes. I don't like these assholes. I don't like these malcontents, but they're a bunch of pissants. They're a bunch of turdlings. And, it is what it is. So now we're going to address a certain individual here. Spewed her mouth open. One of Kevin's friends had actually opened her mouth and said a lot of falsehoods. This woman who in travels, who was a person that I met through a singles line. Okay, and I never met this woman before, and I didn't even know anything about this woman. Met her on a singles line, and she said that she was an independent actress. And Kevin knows her, and Kevin befriends her, and that's cool. That's all cool and fine and dandy. But we're going to target this witch right now and right here on this very show. Right here, right now on this very show. We're going to go ahead and unlayer this whole thing once and for all. This lady in question goes by the name of Sarah Metz. She is an independent actress, and she does other things, and she is... believes in angels, and she's a teacher, I hear. This is a teacher, and she's also a church woman. Oh my God, she's a church woman. Now, she opened up the can of worms to one of these trolls about me and ran her mouth off about me. I'm going to read this garbage, because it is garbage. It's absolute freaking garbage. Recently, okay, hold on. I want to take that thing off here. That's going to stop or whatever. We're gonna go through all this right now here, but I wanna go through this crap, and I'm gonna address this crap right now. And there we go. Once we get this thing set up here, this is what this bitch said to these internet losers. The mistake of befriending this guy, strictly platonic. I had a personal ad out when I came down to Richmond to live closer to my family from the D.C. area. Once 9/11 and the sniper incident was over in 2004, I wanted to come back to a normal, semi-sane environment. Never even kissed this guy, but when he responded about having a TV show, since part of my background was to do indie films and publishing, I let him take me out for drinks one night. When chatted up a storm, once I met him, I realized he was too fat for me. Didn't say that. But it said that we could just be friends, and I wanted to stay in touch due to the film TV interest. Now, let me say one thing. Leathery hag, where in the hell do you call someone fat? Are you 70 years old, 70-year-old plus? I mean, you must be like a leathery old frickin' hag, but I digress. I'm fat? What a joke. Anyway. I met him with his friends, Kevin and a few other locals, in the cable access channel. A bunch mostly at Kevin poking fun at George, who was clueless to it. Then went back home after seeing the film they showed. The next day, George called and asked me if I wanted to see the film again, or come to the filming next week. I said sure, not knowing the next day that I asked him that. I was not sure that if I said sure, not knowing anyone in his county and living a good 55 miles away, with nothing else better to do. I decided to go forth watching and learning more about his show as a platonic friend. I also followed him one night to his home, which is an absolute, and, decreases here. Controlling, so she goes on here and saying that, I can't recall, but I realized his house hadn't been clean in probably years. And then the next week, nothing better to do, went to his cable channel once again. I learned this much about George's personality that he's controlling. He had sex with some, I'm not going to even get into this crap. Because, first of all, bitch, I never told you about anything of my personal life. So that is where you're wrong. We're going to exit that out, because that's a bunch of crap. Bunch of crap from some leathery hag named Sarah Metz. Let's get back to what she says here. Let's get to the part where she starts putting words in Kevin's mouth here. This is what I want to get into here. Hanging with him, abusive, treated their wives like crap. Wait, no, hold on. He called me up 9 a.m. and pissed me off. And finally, I had to say and told him that I was no longer his friend. And kept saying, asking him why. Yeah, right, he was asking why. It just doesn't make any freaking sense here, reading this crap. If you must know, that was the last conversation I had with him when I closed the phone on his face. Angry hate mail from George because he would come across a personal ad of mine on Craigslist with my picture and go freaking nuts. Totally hysterical reaction, calling me old, ugly, and a loser. Yada, yada, yada. I think he could be very scary if let loose. All right. Anyway, enough of this crap here. I go to brunches with Kevin and his friends, but George is never to be around. Let's get into this other crap that she wrote here. I want to read this here. This computer thing is running slow as crap here. Hold on a second. All right, why is this running slow? All right. He's come onto the computer scene net, giving home computers out in 83. Home Access came out in 94. Now she talks about Kevin. Kevin is not married at all, but has some serious relationship, one lasting about 4 years with his fiance, who loved acting and locally abruptly broke it off with Kevin about 3 years ago. Only morons introduce their women to George, Kevin said. If she did get introduced to George, then I'm sure that jealous George made some crack to her to piss her off and insult her. Kevin came out and told me that he never, ever let George get close to any of his at all, never looked at them, and never get around to handle other people or his friends. Having long-term relationships, it would be pretty easy to find out about his criminal background. Okay, whatever. Find out about his criminal background. All right, let me just stop this for once and for all here. First of all, Witch, I met you. When I saw you, you were about below average. Below average, leathery hag. There was never any attraction, but you made some comments. Disgusting. You got your facts all screwed up is what you got. You got your facts all screwed up, and you talk about some other BS about when you met me. I met you, and when I saw you, I didn't think nothing really much of you. You were in you went to a gathering that we went to with some friends. Well, this guy showed his ass. I don't really talk to this guy anymore, and embarrassed you, and, you know, I felt bad about that. Made other comments, disgusting comments, you know, and then you made comments thereafter. Not going to really get into it, so I downplayed that. Then we went out to Tobacco Company, the second go-around. I said, what the hell, why not? Other than the times you've been on, just not even attracted. You made a comment to me. And when you made that hideous comment to me, that's when I ripped you a new one. And I said to you point blank, where the hell do you get off by bashing me, you leathery frickin' hag? You leathery hag. And that's when you closed the phone in front of me. So you have the audacity to sit there and say to me, that I'm hideous, I'm fat, I'm hideous and I'm fat. Let me get something straight to you, Witch Metz. You're the one, okay, that ran your freaking mouth off to these trolls, ran your mouth off and said some other discouraging, disgusting things. I put you in your place. And when I saw your ad on Craigslist, I thought it to be hilarious that some woman that thinks that she's all higher than now, mightier than now, can sit there and pass judgment on me. A school teacher? I find that very hard to believe. A Christian? What a frickin' hypocrite. Don't ask me to go to that church, because they must be filled with frickin' hypocrites. And have her pass judgment on me. Some 70-year-old plus hag passing judgment on me. A mile acquaintance. So let's get the facts straight here on this situation. That's what you are. Putting words in Kevin's mouth. What are you? I mean, do you pull his string or whatever? But we're going to get into that also in a second. Pulling strings and whatnot. Okay? I don't understand that whole crap, but that doesn't, whatever the case might be, it's just kind of screwed up, if you ask me, okay? But I called you, and I emailed you, and I said, what a pathetic piece of SH. Some woman that's going out here begging for a date. So I ripped you because I found it kind of humorous, and I found it kind of funny. Battle axe like you was out on Craigslist, and you were back on Craigslist again, and I ripped you a new one again. And that's how that went down. It went down like that. In a minute, we're going to have Sarah Metz calling here, and she's going to talk to us here. I think we're going to have her on right now. Sarah, how you doing? You got something to say about what you said? Tell me about this. Okay, tell me. You're 81? I don't think so. That's in my system. It's a little test. It's high. I might as well drink some arsenic. Eat it. You get poisoned. Not from you, Jesus. Well, Sarah, you are a disgrace. You're calling up here with a foul mouth tonight? What's up with that? Coming off with a foul mouth tonight on my show? You could take your garbage and ram it down the garbage can, but put yourself in a dumpster. Come over here a second. I got to talk to you, Kevin. It's real quick. Yeah, you're changing the tape. Okay. Okay, I'm talking. So that's, that's really, really disgusting, if you ask me. That is absolutely disgusting and pathetic, you know? So anyway, so she calls up tonight to say that she's advertising herself on Craigslist. And that's what she was advertising. She was advertising her body on Craigslist. And that, she's not 70, she's 81. Kevin, did you realize how old she was? She's not 70, she's 81 years old. God, that's disgusting. And that's she advertised on Craigslist, and now she's called up and made herself even more of a buffoon. Made herself even more of a buffoon by that advertisement. Now, Kevin, what's your take upon all this?
Well, I didn't say any of that. Really, I mean, I do not say anything bad about you or to anybody. Anyone who quotes me, even if they're friends of mine, and I know this woman, she's a very nice woman, very pretty woman, and when people say that I said this is a, unless you hear me say anything, George, and that goes for anything on the internet. I wouldn't say, I always joke that I never say anything bad about anyone or about anybody until I stop talking about my own self. And I never stop talking about my own self.
Comments that she made about bringing your girlfriends over, comments she made about thinking that I'm an outcast and whatnot. We heard her tonight call the show in. What do you think about her comment tonight about selling herself?
Can't comment on that because I didn't sound like the woman I know. But at the same time,
no, that was Sarah Metz calling up here trying to sell herself for prostitution.
I have taken women. You've met lots of my women. Well, I'm sure at least. Well, how many women have I been with? 100.
Okay, so let me get this straight here. So you denounce what she says. She's a liar. She's a liar for putting words in your mouth. Is that correct?
Words in my mouth, I do not denounce anybody. I would not denounce you. I would not denounce any friend of mine. But at the same time, don't pay too much attention to what you hear other people say. If you hear what I say, and I'm saying it right now on the radio, that you're welcome to meet any of my girlfriends, and you're a good, wonderful friend of mine. You've always been good to me, and that there would be no discouraging word I'd ever give to you.
Well, Kevin, I know that, and like I said, I know this, but you see, I had to kind of just address it, because, there's things that go on, things that are said. These internet assholes like to tear things down. These internet assholes like to tear down stuff, and they went on your Facebook. They went on your Facebook, and she had the big blabbermouth, went ahead and called up to said what she said and talk a lot of stuff. And I'm just wondering, what the hell gives with this woman, seriously. Who cares about you shrinking over in the years? You called the show and you ran your mouth off and you're trying to sell yourself. You're coming, you called up tonight, showing your true self, trying to sell yourself tonight, and that's pretty pathetic.
Gave a message to everyone on all my sites. I'm on MySpace and Facebook, and also on. I didn't mention on your site because I don't really know how to access your site, even though I'm on there a lot. But I gave messages to everybody that the nerds, the trolls, the chumps are going to try to contact you. I have to admit, I'm not really worried about these guys. I eat guys like that for breakfast. I've been around, and I can make these guys cry with insults. I've made people cry with insults. May not beat them all up at once, but I could probably, on my worst day, beat. Well, that's not that really tough guy. But anyway, let me tell you, all you have to do is take away their McDonald's and they're hopeless. But let me tell you, I told everybody not to talk to these people, and they've actually put stuff. I mean, I'm like I said, I don't really worry much about it, but But anything you read that I've quote that so and so said, Kevin said this. Kevin never said anything unless you hear me, like right now, saying these things. And I don't, you know, I'm not really worried about being misquoted. But just take with a grain of salt anything you hear about George or myself, because the truth is 180 degrees away. So also, they've actually jacked my one of my pages and put it on YouTube. And they, I think we talked about this last time, and they put a whole bunch of stuff that I said about Gorgeous George. And the Gorgeous George Show, when they were just jokes that I've actually even said on the Gorgeous George Show. They were advertising for people to listen to. If you go to my Facebook page right now, it will direct you to this show. So, with my real name, whatever it is. Do I have a real name? But so I wouldn't give anybody any. I wouldn't even let my mom and dad misquote. I mean, I wouldn't, you know, because they. Kevin said this. Kevin said that. Kevin didn't say anything except right now. And so George, come see my girlfriends anytime. I view you as no threat. Like,
well, like I said, you know, you just gotta consider the source. But, I mean, you know, some things get said, and these are the same malcontents that have been trying their damnedest to put a wedge in between our friendship. These are the same malcontents that put the wedge in between our friendship, and that's all they know how to do. And, you know, it's pretty damn pathetic. Roosevelt, are you back there, sir? Roosevelt, our engineer. I need to get Mr. Roosevelt in here for 1 second, please. Roosevelt. We're having a little issue right here trying to pop this thing. I don't know what's going on. So if you can come over here and just... I want to pop this thing running. I want to pop it out. Okay. That's obviously what we're trying to do is. All right, we got more coming on here. Psychic Brenda Bradshaw will be on here in a little bit. We'll give her a call, and we got another long show to go here. So keep it in tune, because this is the Gorgeous George Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mumble Number 5. In the car, so come on, let's ride to the liquor store around the corner. The boys say they want some gin and juice, but I really don't wanna be a buzz like I had last week. I must stay deep, cause talk is cheap. I like Angela, Pamela, Sandra, and Rita. And as I continue, you know they're getting sweeter. So what can I do? I really value my lord. To me, flirting is just like a sport. Anything fine, it's all good, let me definitely sing in the trumpet. A little bit of Monica in my life, a little bit of Erica by my side, a little bit of Rita's all I need, a little bit of Tina's what I see, a little bit of Sandra in the sun, a little bit of Mary all night long, a little bit of Jessica, here I am, a little bit of you makes me your man. Jump up and down and move it all around. Shake your head to the sound, put your hands on the ground. Take one step left and one step right. One to the front and one to the side. Clap your hands once and clap your hands twice. And if it looks like this, then you're doing it. A little bit of Monica in my life, a little bit of Erica by my side, a little bit of Rita's all I need, a little bit of Tina's what I see, a little bit of Sandra in the sun, a little bit of Mary all night long, a little bit of Jessica, here I am, a little bit of you makes me your man. Number 5. little bit of Monica in my life, a little bit of Erica by my side, a little bit of Rita's all I need, a little bit of Tina's what I see, a little bit of Sandra in the sun, a little bit of Mary all night long, a little bit of Jessica, here I am, a little bit of you makes me your man.
All right, here we go. I don't know who that was. That was a Sarah can call back. All right. What? Okay. Okay, well, 1 second, Brenda. All right, so, okay, we're making sure we got, whoa, hello. God, that was, hello, a lot of verbiage.
Hello.
Okay. All right, this is the Gorgeous George Show, at Vintage Valentine, Inc. Productions. Brenda Bradshaw, our friend from the past, was on the cable access show that's helped us out in the past, is on tonight, and she's going to be talking with the populace out there, talking with us. Brenda, can you hear us?
I can hear you all the way from Florida.
So, Brenda, what do you think about the show thus far?
So good. You are hot tonight, sir.
I'm hot tonight. Well, I'm always hot tonight. Anyway, so, Brenda, tell us now, what are your predictions for 2011?
Predictions? Which one do you want?
10, starting number 10, all the way down. Number 10, starting number 10.
Number 10, Obama signs the job bill. Thank God. And number 9, the Patriots win this. Number 8, overeaters, a pill. Finally, all the fat people. You know the fat people, George?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, but you kind of like, okay. Number 7, people move out of the cities and move west. India and Pakistan have a huge conflict. Number 5, Miss Tina Turner remarried. Angelina Jolie does a rock video. Number 3, Drew Barrymore, she gets a Disney flick. Number 2, Mount Rainier, a huge blast. And number 1 for 2011, cracks around the old faithful geyser at Yellowstone. What do you think, George?
Say number 1 again. I didn't quite catch that.
Number 1, they're cracked, old faithful. You can see these on my YouTube.
There you go. Whoa. Okay, there you go. A lot of reverb, but we're trying to make sure the pod is not reverbing. But, yes, we got that, Brenda. That's very interesting. Very interesting there. All right.
So you have predictions, too, because you're very intuitive, George.
I try to be intuitive. I am intuitive. I am the Mac Daddy. I am, what's causing it. I am the Omega. I am the Aretha. I am what's causing this wonderment for all the ladies out there. And I'm making them kind of giddy right now in the pants right now. So there you go.
Right. So who do you think?
Who do I think? Well, you know who I thought before, but I mean they're not going to be in any playoff contention.
Well,
who I want?
Well, who do you think?
That's not too far from it. I mean the Patriots will have a good team. I kind of like the Saints to repeat actually. Too far from it. I mean the Patriots will have a good team. I kind of like the Saints to repeat actually.
You like who?
I like New Orleans to repeat.
New Orleans, boy, wouldn't that be something?
Yeah, New Orleans repeat. That'd be pretty well.
New Orleans. Super.
Yeah, it'd be
so
super.
We got a lot of people listening tonight. George.
Well, yes, all around the world. They're listening from Pluto. They're listening from Jupiter. They're listening from Africa. They're even listening from Uranus too. I mean, that's what I heard. So I don't know. I don't know. Kevin, what's going on, man? What's that?
I think the Eagles might win the Super Bowl. I'm not saying I'm happy about it. I'm just saying they're looking pretty formidable.
Whoa! I say screw the Eagles.
Brenda's predictions, they have little to do whether you like it or not. I mean, nobody wants to see Mount Rainier blow up, but she claims it's going to happen. So.
Anyway, that's cool. Now, why am I hearing a phone ring on my microphone? There's a phone that's ringing on my microphone. I feel like it's like a shoe phone or something, perhaps.
Shoe phone?
I don't know. Kevin, do you have a shoe phone you're wearing right now? What the hell's going on?
Right now. Would you believe? Sorry about that, Chief.
shoot on the screen.
You know this guy, the shoot bomb? The guy, Richard Reed?
Well,
no one predicted that.
What's that now, Brenda?
65 degrees.
I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear that. Come on now.
It was so nice, I was wearing shorts.
Let me ask you a question. Did you hear that lovely call from Miss Metz tonight?
I did. I could barely hear her, but she sounded like a bat, a witch.
She sounded like a witch, didn't she? Could you hear what she said?
I did. I could barely hear her, but she sounded like a bat, a witch.
She sounded like a witch, didn't she? Could you hear what she said?
I didn't hear. All I heard was something about her doing some kind of selling her body.
She's selling her body. Well, yeah, she called twice, too, you know?
Think somebody wants to buy her body?
She called twice about it. I didn't know what the hell to make out of it, you know? I mean, she already embarrassed herself on Craigslist and trying to, you know, and then she's embarrassing herself on my radio show. Embarrassed herself on Craigslist.
It takes all kinds of people to run the world. I'm glad you're my friend.
I'm glad to have you as a friend as well, Brenda. And we're going to spread the word.
I'm just Richmond, and I'm just being on your show. I get to watch it. Thank God for YouTube.
Up the Gorgeous Georgia on YouTube.
Kevin,
you don't get the best of the Gorgeous Giorgio on YouTube unless it says GG on DVD or something like that.
Okay, Brenda, I need you to turn down your radio because I can hear myself.
Well, I couldn't hear you, so you disappeared on me.
Oh, okay, I'm right here. No, Kevin said if you want to hear the best, you hear it on Gorgeous Giorgio on DVD. But then you said thank God for YouTube. I'm
trying.
Yes, unvarnished. Yeah. So that's why. But no, I'm here. It's a little reverb going on here. So then it's like seven.
About the new rule about internet tonight that the Congress signed a bill. Government's trying to come in and take over the internet company. The government to take over the internet company today.
I say bravo. I think that the internet needs to be policed. I hate to say that, but I believe the internet should be policed.
George, we're losing everything.
I said I think the internet should be policed.
Okay, but we're losing all our privacy.
I understand that, and you know, privacy there, you know, I get that, but then there's but what I go through,
right.
I mean, a few people ruin it for other people.
But maybe we do need a little bit.
A few people ruin it for other people, and that's sad, but it's the case.
What Kevin said
about cyberbullying, or bullying in general, even in the schoolyard. So the idea that just because people have freedom of speech doesn't mean they should be able to use it to intimidate people.
Y'all disappear.
Can you hear Kevin? Kevin's talking.
I was talking. Now I can hear myself very well. And now. Anyway, so Brenda, I was noticing now, it's what I didn't know you moved to Florida. What's going on in Florida for you? I think, she's...
Okay, Brenda, are you there? Brenda.
I was listening. This bully thing has gone too far.
They don't have anything like that in Florida, do they? With Charlie Crist, new governor. Yeah, she's like, she's going in and out.
Brenda, your pod is fading in and fading out a little bit. I'm not sure what's causing that, but it's fading in and fading out. We're trying to get that fixed. Probably the full moon. Could be the full moon. And we got Roosevelt in here trying to help adjust that. Thank you, sir. He's adjusting that.
It's not Roosevelt Greer, the famous player for the Giants and the Rams.
It's Franklin Roosevelt.
Franklin Roosevelt,
the president. Franklin Delano or Roosevelt.
Well, it's the ghost of Franklin Roosevelt. That's the ghost.
All right. So there you go. Now, I think I hear myself better. Brenda, speak so we can hear you.
I'm here.
Okay. Making sure we can hear you. All right, so you heard everything thus far, but so you do agree with what I'm saying about the internet needs to be thus far the internet should be policed in some way. You think?
I'm just worried about competition with businesses,
right?
And capitalism going down the tube.
Roosevelt, are we able to get Paul's going to react with Brenda? Only one line. Okay, that's fine. Unfortunately,
we should tell your fortune then.
Well, no. Let's talk. What predictions do you see for the Gorgeous George show in general? Not just me, but for the show.
I want to see you go for the bucks.
Okay,
the money.
That's right. Well, that's what I need to do.
And you know, I have so many suggestions for George. I really think he'd make a great spokesman.
Yeah.
And I don't know what y'all think in the audience. Maybe y'all should call him and tell him, encourage him, because he really can sell. He can do it.
Well, now, let me ask you this now. Well, what do you think, Lo? Do you think that the show will ever be syndicated?
George, the DVD thing's a good deal. I know that. But as far as your show being syndicated, the best thing to do is we got to take it to Los Angeles. We got to take it to California.
Right. Well, I agree. What I need to do is get a legitimate agent. A legitimate agent involved with this production and then go from there with it.
Most definitely, but really, I'm going to work on this. I've been working on it. I'm just going to make some good connections with some major stars.
Well, Brenda.
I've done a lot of reading. Matt Lauer on the Today Show, I read his fortune, told him he was going big back when he was in Richmond on PM Magazine.
Well, that's a long time ago.
That's right.
I was about 10 years old back then.
You were in diapers.
I was like 10 years old.
10 years old?
Now, we know that Kevin, hold on a second, I'm going to probably do Kevin's mic down. We know that Kevin was bathed until age 13.
Doing what till age 13?
His parents still bathed him until he was age 13.
That's 13 years of my life. And then at 14, I found other nice women to do it for me.
Brenda, say what? I'm sorry. Say that again, Brenda.
That's how long he was.
It was the best 30 years of my life.
I believe that.
Well, I believe that, when I see a woman in an airport or if I'm in an airplane and a woman is breastfeeding her kid, that makes me jealous.
That
makes me jealous. I don't care if it's a baby or I don't care if it's her next of kin. When I see that baby sucking on that breast, I take that. I said, ma'am, I said, listen here, I want some milk. She said, what are you, some freak? I said, lady, if you don't move that kid's head, I'm putting my face down there and I'm going to suck your nipples and get some breast milk.
These women had pulled their boobs out. I was in, and that is the normal thing. Women pull their boobs out all the time.
Well, I mean.
Let's move to Korea then.
Well, just know, though, that Korea, that, now, you know what they do? Now, in North Korea and in South Korea, they cane people if they misbehave. Maybe some of these assholes on the internet need to be caned.
I think we better do something with them. I tell you one thing. We're going to clean this. We're going to clean the internet.
This is what I'm going to do. Brenda, I'm going to have you take care of my light work for me.
That's what I'm here for.
Brenda, and I know you can do it. I don't have to do any more. I don't have to say any more. Trolls out there, you internet trolls. Brenda is in the house. And Brenda is going to take care of the situation because not only is she clairvoyant, she also, not only is she psychic, she also has a lot of, she also internet savvy. She also has a lot of internet savvy. Internet savvy. Internet savvy. And she's going to knock you out. It's like bug spray.
Congratulations on my site. 15-minute videos. That means that I can run the show.
Well, Brenda, I do appreciate it.
We got to run, right?
Well, no, I don't have to run. I can keep you on. I mean, why? I mean, you got to go to bed or what? What's up?
No, I don't. But last night, I was up at 3:30 in the morning watching that moon. You didn't see it, did you? Last night, I was up at 3:30 in the morning watching that moon. You didn't see it, did you?
The only thing that I know about the moon is when the full moon, and when there's a full moon, I become the
doubt it.
I become a werewolf.
You see, a lot of people are affected by that full moon. And about it is, last night, I think the trolls were affected by it.
You think they were?
Because it turned all red, reminding them that they are definitely redheads.
There's a guy that used to do one of the guys that used to be on one of the shows back in 2004. We called him Red Pube Face because he had a face like a pubic, red pube face.
Right, got it.
Yeah,
right.
And his father, his father was Dennis Rader, the BTK killer.
God.
The BTK killer. I have left you out for dead.
He's on the wall, Kevin. He's on the wall, honey. When he's on the wall, just hit him back as hard as you can.
I just said, this is Dennis Rader. Son, leave me alone. I'm out there going ahead and playing with the ladies, and I'm out there killing ladies. I don't need to report to you. But Daddy, you make me so dysfunctional. Why are you out there doing this to these ladies? You did it to Mom. You put her and you stuffed Mama up, and she's a taxidermist. And you did her and you stuffed her up with, and yeah, you're doing it to these ladies. You made me such a dysfunctional person. Well, shut up there, Red Pube Face. I did it because I did it for you. And now leave me alone. And that was a skit we did.
That's great. He's off and running, people. Yeah. He is the Robin Williams right here incarnate. Man has talent in every inch of his body.
Well, now, for the ladies, I have talent in a certain spot. And, like I said in that song when she said, Kevin's talking about his one incher, but I'm not worried about that one incher. I'm talking about what... You know, the girl said, she said, Gigi, do you want to bust my cherry, you know, tonight? And I said, sure. I said, I didn't know you were a virgin. She said, well, that's, yeah. She said, well, for Gigi tonight, I'll pretend like I'm a virgin. You know, like Madonna said, just like, you know, like a virgin, you know, touch for the very first time.
Right, right.
So I just bust her cherry and pretend she's a virgin. And then she'll go out to the plateau where, you know, her clitoris gets all teased, you know, but I just stick it in there. And she says, how do you like that? She said, oh, I'll do anything you want me to. Just stick it in me. So there
sure.
you go.
Have you got a song to sing for us? I love to hear you sing.
I already did the songs earlier. Yeah,
I missed it because my computer was down.
You missed it? Okay.
But go ahead. You want to hear
the song again? Okay. All right. Let's see this. Go here. Chestnuts roasting on an open rack. Chestnuts roasting on an open rack. La da da da. Gigi nipping at those breasts. Gigi nipping at those breasts. Yuletide tot, with her eyes are glow, we'll find it hard to sleep tonight. Cause they know that Gigi is on his way, filling up all the pantyhose and stockings with his sleigh. And every sister and mother's mother is gonna spy to see if Gigi can stick it out. I'm offering this simple phrase. Da, 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 da. Ladies from 1 to 97, although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Clitmas, Merry Clitmas to you. Kevin, go ahead.
And if you go to all those pretty girls, age of 1 to 92, please save me a few between 18 and 30, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you.
And although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Clitmas to you. There you go.
That is copyright.
Here we go. It was Dasher and Prancer and Bubba and Skillet, Freddy and Grady and Yanni and Linson. But do they know the famous Italian stallion of them all? Gigi and his big schlong decker had a real schlong for the ladies. And they all knew that it was special. And they wanted to have Gigi drive them away. Then came one foggy Christmas Eve. Blonde bombshell came to say, Gigi, if you want to put it inside of me and bust me open, wouldn't you drive me home tonight? Then how all the other trolls were, they knew that Gigi had it going on. Okay, I'll lose the track here. Along schlong, let me drive you home, Miss Daisy. I sang it and I lost the words to it. There you go. Copyright there also. Okay.
Listen, you got an applause meter button there. You could push that button.
There's an applause meter? Well, here you go.
No, there's a button on the panel, isn't there, for different sound effects?
You know what? I did not bring that with me. I was such in a rush, but I'm looking on here for that.
I thought there was an
applause. Okay, well, here you go. There's the applause.
That's one person.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, it's 1,000 people.
Right on, baby. That's what I told you.
All right.
But he's got an excellent memory.
What is the sound of one hand clapping?
You reckon there's anybody awake? He'll listen to it?
You know, I don't know if there is or there isn't, but I'm going to take some phone calls, and I'm going to, in such a way where I'm going to probably do some, I might rip some people tonight. But Brenda, we will talk to you. I appreciate you calling us. I wanted you to interreact with some of the calls, tell some fortunes. What, before we let you go, though,
yes,
what else can you tell us prediction-wise?
Well, I just want to say one thing, that I know Christine Hefner, Hugh Hefner's daughter, personally, and I'm going to call her and see if I can get you and Kevin an invite to the mansion.
Oh, my goodness gracious, Brenda, seriously.
Brenda,
are you going to let me and Kevin see? I mean, because when I was in L.A.,
yes.
I was out there near Hefner's pad, and
right.
Security told me you can't come in, invite only.
She's one of my special clients, and I'm going to give her a ring.
Well, I would love to meet Mr. Hefner. Hugh Hefner,
yes.
You know, I mean, get him in there, and then, you know, have the pool and all that. Kevin,
right.
can you imagine?
Well, pull that off.
I think y'all would fit in real well there, so I'm going to give Christine a call, okay?
I fit in everywhere. The two of us fit everywhere. But let me tell you something, Brenda. If you could pull that off,
Merry
Well, Brenda, before you go, hello, before you, whoa.
I'm here. What?
Like I said, yeah, if you can make that happen, that would be great. You know, hey, that would be great. We bring you, too. I mean, you know, the sky's the limit.
I'm just going to call Christine and tell her, because I did a reading for her when she was in Richmond, and I told her she was going to be, and that was when she was doing fashion for the magazine. She said never going to happen, and she is CEO now.
All right, Brenda, we will talk. I appreciate
all
it very
right.
much. Thank you much. And react with some of the people, but that's quite all right.
Not these people.
All right, I know what we got here. All right, you're on the air with Gorgeous George and friends. Talk to us.
George.
Yes, can we help you?
Yes, I was going to ask you about the oil rig.
All right, may I ask who's calling? Evan, okay, you're calling from Georgia.
Yeah, the oil rig situation.
All right, give us your take on that.
All right, they all say...
You're breaking up, sir.
Yeah, they all say that BP for the oil rig situation, but check this out. The oil rigs were not built by BP. They were built by a British company. You guys are faggots.
All right, and you know what? You can take your donkey... And you can take your, you know, take it, and you can go ahead and have sex with your freaking donkey there. If I have a problem with you, buddy, if you were in 50 yards of me, your head would be splatted like a freaking splat. We've got your number. If you were ever in my vicinity, I would splat your head wide freaking open. That's why condoms were created for sperm like you. Condoms were created to black out the sperm like you for even existing to uttering a word. So if you got something to say, it's equivalent to turdlings going down a toilet. Turdlings going down a toilet. I don't know, having herpes. Because you probably got STDs from your mother. Now, we don't want to hear this crap. Take your shit and flush your head and meet and eat and greet your log. Thank you very much. I got your BP for you. I got your BP for you in the form of an enema. Where the sun doesn't shine, you freaking... Now, we don't take phone calls from Alberta, so we're going to go bye-bye. No calls from Alberta. That's right. I got his BP for him. I got his BP for him in a royal enema. You see, this is why we don't do it on the live TV show. We don't do it on the live TV show. We're going to do it tonight because I feel like ripping some people. Brendan Candace. What? Okay, I'm gonna reserve judgment here in a second. I'm gonna reserve judgment. Brendan, you're on the air.
Hey, how's it going? I could completely understand that, George. I wanted to talk to you about your show.
Oh, 1 second. Is this the Brendan that did that spoof on me on YouTube? Is this the Brendan that did the spoof on me on YouTube?
Well, thank you. I just wanted to say I moved out to California recently. I've been a big fan of your shows for years, and I absolutely loved you on Hoarders.
I didn't catch that.
One of those channels people watch when they're bored. The what show? You know, let me tell you something about cable television. It's like, I mean, we're better than all these teenage mothers that are having all these kids. And we're better than...
Kevin, I need you to explain that to me one more time. What was that joke about?
First, but there's Quarters is a show about where someone comes and cleans someone's house.
All right, we got 570-447-5807. It must be that clown from Camden, Pennsylvania. Camp Hill, Pennsylvania. And I could almost guarantee I know who this is here. 570-447-5807. It must be that clown.
I just wanted to know, if you could go back and change anything in history, what would it be?
Well, if I had to go back in history and change anything, I would change the fact that you were born. Thank you very much. Matter of fact, I would happen to maybe go ahead and tell your daddy to stick it in his pants. I'm sorry. All right. You like that one? Okay.
I can't believe after... Out of 500 million sperm, that was the winner.
Yeah. No, to answer your question, no. I would ask more people to wear condoms, and maybe a lot of people like the element of trash out there was even, you know. We're not taking unknown calls, so that's on my bad on that one. That's okay. That's what. Yeah. What did I think of that? Well, no, I can't because it's on my phone. Unfortunately, we can't. That's unfortunate. Unfortunately, we can't. But wait a second. Maybe we can do something real fast here. Yes, I think maybe we can. Let me make sure of something. Well, nah, probably not. Is it time for commercial? We have another call from the same person. We don't believe in commercials. I'm trying to get that person to call back, that character. So anyway, so we pretty much have combed it out, man. We called a spade a spade. You know, we putting words in your mouth. I mean, that was uncool, wasn't it, Kevin?
Nobody should put words in anyone's mouth.
And What she did was kind of tasteless.
What? I do not approve of anyone misquoting. Bad mother. She's a very nice, lovely woman. And if you disagree with that, why are you worried about an ugly hag saying stuff about you?
Excuse me now, what's that?
I think you're bigger than that, and I don't think you should worry about what ugly hags and ugly witches have to say about you.
Let me say something here. I took it kind of personal. I took it very freaking personal, okay? These people have no freaking life. They have no life. They were that desperate to go ahead, and any of your other people who had common sense to tell them to go blank themselves. And unfortunately, this woman, she wanted to blab, and she got called out on that. You know, I mean, she wants to blab, and this guy, you know, the SOB himself goes ahead and is desperate. He's self-loathing, and he wants to go ahead and make a comment. So he got her, and she said what she said. She talked and talked and talked and said other stuff, and she's a liar. She's a first-class liar.
Big guy on YouTube that can't get off the couch.
Yeah. Should we do a roll call, Kevin?
Ambulatory. We're actually rather, we could actually move around. I mean, I don't know when the last time, I mean, this guy needs a mirror. Just to pleasure himself when he's looking at the underwear ads in the Sears.
Yeah, you know, I'm thinking about whether we should do a roll call. Da-da-da. It's the Price is Right. It's time to get all the trolls and call them by their name. Joshua Miller from Camp Hill, Pennsylvania. You pig face. Come on down. Oh, my goodness gracious. Nick Morano from New Jersey. Nick Rock, you imbecile. Come on down, you piece of shit. Oh, Christian Thurston. Decayed Matter. What a piece of SH. Hey, Christian Thurston. When's the last time you put a dildo up in your side of you? Come on down from Madison, Wisconsin. Come on down. Big fat blob that squats on the squatter machine in Wilmington, North Carolina. Leighton Jonathan Armin, you imbecile that takes dildos up the ass when he squats. Come on down. Oh, my goodness gracious. Who else are we missing here? Oh, from the Bronx, New York. How can I forget? Puerto Rican half-breed. Pubic hair. Puerto Rican half-breed. Luis B. Calix with pubic hair on his head. Pubic hair. Luis B. Calix with pubic hair on his head. Thinking he's hot stuff. Come on down. Thinking he's hot stuff. Oh, you're the next imbeciles on The Price is Wrong. Come on down. Michael Rafferty from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Pube face. Come on down, red pube face. What are you doing to yourself right now? Are you pleasuring yourself, you piece of SH? I tell you what. You know what I think? I think it's time for a roll in. I'm a Joshua Miller, you pig-faced little twerk. Camp Hill, Pennsylvania. We got your number. Luis Calix, half-breed Puerto Rican, pubic hair. Pube hair for hairdo. We have some music coming on here. Oh, I didn't know we have some late music coming on here. Oh, my God, an hour and a half has already gone by. Hell, I don't know what we got here. Kevin, tell you. Chipmunk! We got you on the air, Chipmunk. What's going on?
Hello? Hey, yes, this is Chipmunk. This is on the King of
You're a loser. Thank you very much. When's the last time you got screwed by your mother? Oh, boy, I tell you what. You know, yeah, they bring out the best out of me, you know that? And it feels good to just rip them.
You should be on Fox News. You inspire people so much. You would blend right in with Beck and Sarah Palin. Bill O'Reilly.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, I think we have a phone call right here. It might be that phone call that we're looking for. It's Sarah Metz. It must be Sarah Metz call.
Hello, my name is Mary Sue. I'm 81 years old. Yeah. I got silver hair. I used to be 5'7", but I shrunk over the years. But I'm looking for someone that can treat me right. I love getting my pussy. Tell you what, this is best. Sit on my hover round new. And you can spread my titties and eat my pussy. There's nothing like it, my pussy.
My God, not again. Not again.
It's a little dusty. It's a little powdery down there. So you might want to get water. Just wet up a little bit.
Sarah, give it up.
Well, she can dry throat. Get cotton mouth. You don't want cotton mouth, do you? I didn't think so. So if you want some of this pussy, you just call this number right here, honey.
Sarah, you are pathetic. Miss Metz, you are totally pathetic. That's you. calling again. We've already denounced you on Craigslist, and then you're calling up here to talk a bunch of rubbish. We denounced you on Craigslist to talk a bunch of rubbish. We know you're pathetic. Hello, you're on the air.
I just want to say for Christmas, I'm thankful that I banged Sue and gave her a ring.
You're thankful for being on this earth, because if your daddy would have kept it in his pants, your ass wouldn't have been on this earth. You are a moron. Take it somewhere else. Yeah, we only got 4 minutes left in the show here. Damn it, time goes by fast. Kevin, Kevin?
Christmas and happy 2011. And it's been a good 10 or so years, and it's been a good 5 or 6 years out of 14. No, we've had a wonderful time, and here's more.
What are some New Year's resolutions you got? You got any New Year's resolutions?
Yeah, because I'm doing very well. Pistachio nuts that don't open. You know, the ones you have to throw against the wall? Those are
You're on the air.
Hey, George, it's Gigi Yanks the Sausage. You're still a fat fuck. I'd like to wish George a Merry Christmas.
All right, anyway, whatever. Joshua Mock. I thought you were Joshua whatever you were. Faggot name is that? Call him my damn answering service. Guy is an imbecile. Come on, I don't need to tell you that.
I mean, if they had girlfriends, they wouldn't be calling you.
That's their problem. They whack their sausage, you know? They whack their sausage.
to the National Geographic.
Look, you know what? It's going on 10:28, and I just have to say, that's it with the phone calls. We experimented with that. Now, let's just say this right here. The Gorgeous George Show is still, I'm not worried. I'll wrap it up. We got 2 more minutes here. I'm going to wrap it up. We got 2 more minutes, right? I'm going to say it. Now you see, I just lost my train of thought here. What'd you do that for? No, I am, listen here. You know, the bottom line is, whether you like me or don't like me, I don't care, okay? I am what is in control here. I'm in control. I have a life. I have a private life. And I keep my private life separate from anything else. So you all can keep whacking your sausage like Mr. Miller does and like Louis B. Kalix. They whack their sausage because they have no life, because they're pathetic. They're pathetic, and they go out there and they stir trouble. I, on the other hand, have a life. Captain Kirk told the damn trolls, get a life. I mean, do something productive. Screw a woman. Play with your boyfriend's ASAC. Do something. Just get a freaking life. Do something productive. You know, the daddy should have kept it in his pants. He should have wore a condom. That's the moral of the story on this Christmas, December the 21st. And, I've had it. I've said what I needed to say. All right, so, Kevin, we're here. We're going to keep it up. We've got the Gorgeous George Show on DVD. We got 2010. Everything is lovely. Everything is great. What's causing all this? And Kevin and I will be friends. Kevin and I will stay friends. He's a part of the show. And all you naysayers, go rub dogs with your freaking daddy and get a freaking life and go to hell, okay? Merry Clintmas and a Happy New Year to all my fans and to the trolls. Go to hell, and may the devil torture you with a pitchfork up your arse.
You all have a hell of a night.